Apple recently introduced their new MacBook Pro models, and one of their most controversial features is the notch. We already know why it was necessary on iPhone, but why MacBook Pro? Well, it happened to solve a lot of issues for Apple, starting with the display. The previous MacBook Pro models had 13.3 and 16-inch displays, which weren't necessarily small, but could have been bigger, considering their bezels were fairly thick compared to other notebooks. So to modernize the MacBook Pro's display, Apple wanted to reduce its bezel up to 60%, but that caused a problem. The MacBook Pro's top bezel housed the FaceTime camera, green LED indicator, and ambient light sensor. Shrinking the bezel would mean removing these components from the display. So to maximize screen real estate without sacrificing features, a notch was added. This not only allowed for a higher quality 1080p FaceTime camera, but it also allowed for the menu bar to be pushed out of the user's content area, occupying space previously used by the bezel. For example, the 16-inch model still delivers the same active screen area, except that its menu bar can be pushed up and out of the way, making those 16 inches more usable than before. Plus, when an app enters full screen mode, the active area can remain the same size, while the menu bar simply fades away, essentially leaving a black bezel like before. Except the menu bar can be summoned by the user without covering up their workspace. Previously, calling up the menu bar in full screen mode would cause toolbars to shift downward, covering up a portion of the user's content area. And Apple implemented the notch in a pretty clever way, ensuring it didn't interfere with any on-screen elements. For example, menu bar options are automatically spaced out on the other side of the notch instead of being covered up. And if the cursor is moved from one side of the menu bar to the other, it doesn't get hung up on the notch, since Apple allows the cursor to move behind it seamlessly. That also means, for the first time ever, the cursor has a hiding spot on the display, which can be helpful while watching videos or movies. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.